Hello everyone, I'm GameOnBrad, and this is The Witcher Wild Hunt. I haven't played this game in a long time, but I recently saw the Blood and Wine expansion was released, and I didn't have Heart of Stone either, so I bought both expansions, and then I realized that I was really rusty. So instead of continuing from where I left off, I think I was at level 9 originally when I first started the game and stopped playing. I think I was at level 9. So instead of starting from there, I'm gonna actually just start over. I was playing it before I had my YouTube channel. So now I'm gonna add this video series to my YouTube channel as well. I know it's a bit older if you don't want to watch it. So what? I like this game. So I'm gonna actually play it and I'm gonna use my YouTube videos as a reason for finishing it to give me motivation to actually complete the series. So I'm not gonna quit this time. But yeah, it's better if I start over from scratch. And just so I get used to it. Yeah, we're gonna do just the story. I'm not gonna go higher than this. I tried story and sword before. That was pretty good, but I got my ass handed to me enough times. No, thank you. Let's go with just the story for now. Maybe in the future I'll do a one-off video that's, that just shows you how difficult, like, the higher levels are. Hell, I don't even remember the cinematics. Like this is totally new to me. Well, he's obviously tracking her. Witcher Keep. Oh yeah, I remember how many scars he had. Guy's seen tons of battles.
don't find that amusing.
It wasn't meant to amuse, but to prod you to hurry. It's midday already. You promised Ciri you'd train with her. Go before Vesemir bores her to death with those etchings.
Scars much?
So, later then.
See you later.
She doesn't have a single scar on her entire body. I love how they don't show his butt, but they show hers. And they show her butt again. It's like, what about his butt? Equal opportunity. Come on now. All right, now I'm remembering this. Okay, game's core elements. Minimap, yep.
Got any clothes that aren't black or white?
Undergarments.
See, I thought Ciri could stand to wait a little longer.
It's uninstructive, not to mention unreasonable.
Let's do I want to stay with you a little longer.
I missed you.
It's romantic.
And I missed you. But we'll have plenty of time to make up for that. Go and train with her, then come back. It'll give me a chance to put my face on.
Of all the women I've known, you're the only one who does that before.
You've known many.
What's it matter? Only ever thought of you.
Oh. I don't know if that's a nice thing to say regardless. Locked. He walks a little stiff.
You're running out of juice.
I know. You might bring me some more once you're done training.
Juice. It's more like liquor. Lots and lots of liquor.
Nothing but silver.
Gold flashes with my complexion.
I don't know. Extinguish. Ooh, fancy. Is that it? Did I detect everything? I want to keep her warm. Yeah, let's head outside. Oh, actually, we could head downstairs.
Witcher's fast asleep. Ciri's disappeared somewhere, of course.
This game is, what, a little over a year and a half old? It still looks fantastic.
Guess she prefers practice to theory.
What?
Time to wake up, Master. These lessons so boring they put you to sleep too?
Damn it. After taking notes on ghouls and alghouls, wanted to rest my eyes a bit.
Making her slog through that brick? No wonder she took off.
John of Bruges lacks flair, true, but he's reliable. Not like the hogwash they print nowadays. She's tackling the pendulums, right?
Yes, she is.
How many times do I have to tell her? Don't train alone. It only embeds your errors. Bring our young damsel to the lower courtyard. She wants to practice, she'll get to practice.
It's true. If you don't have somebody to actually teach you, your bad habits will be compounded.
Don't get mad at her.
Why the hell not? The whippersnapper refuses to do as she's told.
You like that about her.
Fine. I suppose I'm partly to blame. But this has to end. Now. Killing monsters is not something to be taken lightly. Ciri must understand that if she's to become one of us. I'll see you below.
She really wants to become one of us.
Wrong. Now I see why you were so eager to practice. Strike.
Oh, mistake.
Circus pirouette. Wrong. Footwork.
I just remembered by the close-up there, she's wearing a blindfold.
Enough.
Which is impressive regardless.
With a flip?
What do you think? All right. Take off the blindfold. You've got work to do. Your reflexes are still slow.
Maybe for a witcher.
Think drowners or striggers will go easy on you because you haven't undergone the mutations? Though in your shoes, I'd fear Vesemir more than any strigger. Disobeying his instructions? Unwise.
Well, yes, but that book was horribly dull.
I know, and you know that's no excuse.
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
Better not. Vesemir said if it does, he'll make you eat a bowl of slugs covered in salt.
You!
Exactly. So you'd best behave. Come on, we'll practice with the others down below.
Shall we run the walls?
Sure. Let's begin the tutorial.
Of course. Is a witcher school or an elven bathhouse?
To the bottom.
It's not something you should say to a kid.
Fall. Tell you about breathing through your mouth in rhythm with your steps. Ciri, cut it out.
She climbs down. I just jump. It's more efficient. Oops. Actually, she did a better job of that than I did.
Geralt? What is it?
Nothing. I'm just an amateur trying to get back into it. I have less skills than you do, but you know, let's not. I beat her. She's not gonna win, even if she's a child. I refuse. Oh, check his face out. I don't remember that at all.
Anything to say for yourself, young lady?
I'm very sorry, Uncle Vesemir.
Young blood craves action, I understand that. But when you fight a beast, knowledge counts as much as your silver sword. At the very least, you ought to be able to tell a ghoul from an owl ghoul.
By markings, like unto the panthera tigris that in Zeracania dwells, and by the sickly paleness of its visage.
She knows her shit.
I did read the chapter. Still, you should have asked if...
But you were asleep, Uncle Vesemir.
Oh, snap. Oh, snap.
So yeah. You did the reading. Why not admit it right off?
Never pounce on an advantage as soon as it appears. Wait till it stands to have maximum effect. Uncle Vesemir's words.
Well, you're a quick study. Quick, but mischievous.
Yeah, she is mischievous for sure.
Fine. We've talked enough. Geralt, you're with me. Lambert with Eskel. Ciri with a dummy.
Again?
Stop groaning and grab a sword.
Uh-oh, he's gonna kick my ass. I remember when I did this the first time, he kicked my ass.
The fundamentals or go right to free training?
Let's do fundamentals.
Should work on the basics.
It's been so long, I need the basics.
Need to hone the fundamentals.
His eyes are so cool. Ciri's barely a novice. I'm barely a novice. Alright. Witcher senses to hold. Okay, sprint, left shift, jump space, draw your sword. Z to select the target. As you can see, I'm playing on PC.
One, two, three. Strong strikes now. Give it all you got. Never lock your elbow when striking, young lady. What the blazes are you doing? Tomfoolery, enough. This will be quick. Dodge.
Position, Ciri. Footwork. Remember.
Slow as a fly trapped in amber today. Do it again. Come on, at them.
Damn you. Oh yeah, the rolling. I forgot about the rolling. I like completely forgot about rolling.
Now, parry. Ciri, see how Geralt holds his sword.
Oh, come on!
What am I supposed to parry?
Now, live later.
Yeah, exactly.
Strike! Counter-strike!
Okay, press just before strike. A counter-strike.
Maybe a storm's coming.
I'm doing a lot better this time than I did last time. He kicked my ass last time. Ouch.
Who's next?
Come on.
Now, young lady. bring the day to a close, we'll go over a few witcher signs. Let's start with Quen.
Yeah, let's do Quen.
Ciri, Quen is sometimes called the Witcher's Shield. Ciri, Quen is sometimes called the Witcher's Shield. Now watch carefully to see why.
Yes, it protects me from damage. I am immortal.
Cast Igni, Geralt. I want to see sparks fly. See? If not for the Quen sign, I'd be aflame by now. All right, Geralt, come on! Well, come on! See that, Ciri? Ours will knock anyone or anything off. Time for Axie. Damn it. I hate this feeling.
Why do you hate it so?
Axie can really muddle your mind.
He's my guinea pig right now for the tutorial. All to teach Ciri.
Show her, Geralt.
Yurden.
See this, Ciri? Couldn't move if I wanted to. Throw a bomb. Don't worry, Ciri. Quen will dampen the blow. Enough. Continue training at will.
You go, girl.
Whoa, you really showed him, kid.
Ciri, get down here.
A little she-devil. Soon as she's back, we'll set her to polishing all the swords at Kaer Morhen.
I thought we got attacked here.
Find that helmet. Ciri? I'll make sure to find every last blade for you.
Is that real blood?
What the?
So was it reality or was it a dream?
You all right?
Had a nightmare.
About?
Take forever to explain.
Dawn's some way off. We've got time.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Started in the guest room at Kaer Morhen. I was relaxing in the tub, and next to me...
Triss?
Yennefer. Funny, isn't it? She's never been there. Seemed so real in my dream, though.
Was she nagging you about
something? So it is a dream. It was all a dream.
Mm-hmm.
True to life, indeed. We'll find her.
Let's keep talking.
In the dream, I went and found Ciri. Then we trained.
Those were the days. Little she-devil.
He said that in the dream, too.
I've trained kids who were faster, stronger, but none had
her character.
Didn't end well, did it? Your dream.
Nope.
No. A wild hunt appeared, attacked Ciri. I couldn't move, stood there like a stump.
It was just a dream.
Let's do number two.
That's the problem.
I was thinking more. It's a premonition.
In the past, when Ciri'd appear in my dreams, something was wrong. She was in danger.
We taught her how to defend herself from anything, wraiths included.
Okay. So she was fully taught, but where did she go?
Wait. Show me the letter from Yennefer. Might have overlooked some hint in there.
Didn't overlook anything. We were meant to meet in Willoughby. That's what she wrote. Meanwhile, one army or another burned the village to the ground. All we can do is follow her trail, so...
Stop talking for a minute and give me the letter. Oh. How about that? It does smell of lilac and gooseberries.
You were gonna read it, not sniff it.
We must meet soon. Willoughby near Vizima. Nothing else to guide us there. What's this postscript? I still have the unicorn?
That's private. Let's do stuffed unicorn.
Stuffed unicorn. Used it once or twice. Certain situations.
Oh boy.
The things young folk get up to these days.
Back on topic. How's it look? How far behind Yennefer are we?
2 or 3 days. Trail's fresh. But it looks like it leads towards the main road. Could be muddled there. Wait. Hear that?
The horse looks a bit spooked.
Ghouls.
Uh-oh.
For this shit.
What now, piece of filth?
Pass, necrophages follow. Let's go before any more show up.
Where are you, little guy? There you are.
Ever tell you about this sorcerer I knew? Couldn't stop talking about how useful they are as creatures.
Because you can brew.
Let's turn down the sensitivity of the mouse, since it's a little bit too sensitive.
Potions from their blood?
No, because by eating rotting corpses, they prevent epidemics.
Did he know they eat the living as well?
No. Really upset him, too. His theory collapsed.
war is not exactly going our way.
We have a side.
The Northern Realms.
Radovid's realms, don't you mean? Temeria and Edirne are no more.
Radovid's pledged to restore the old borders as soon as he wins the war.
Believe that?
Gotta believe something. It's what keeps us going.
I love how the casual conversation tells the story between the two characters. It's very cool. It's a nice touch. Yeah, this game hasn't aged a day. It still looks beautiful. Uh-oh. Sometime later. Ooh, sunburst. Uh-oh. I remember this. Coward. How dare you fly off? Poor guy. He's getting slower in his old age.
Has it gone?
Yeah. It's come out.
How are you supposed to pull your cart now?
Gods, that was close. I was sure I'd end up like my mare.
Provided you got lucky.
Your horse died quickly, but griffons like to toy with their prey, eat it alive, piece by piece.
Wow, let's get more graphic, why don't we?
You'd like a reward, I suppose.
Let's do the you don't know us anything.
You were in need, we helped.
And they call witches heartless, say they won't lift a finger without pay.
They also say mice are born of rotting straw. Back to the trail.
Like maybe I should do everything for money.
The main road and ends there.
Instead of being a good Samaritan. Someone?
Yes, a woman. Medium height, long black hair. Seen anyone like that?
No, but there's an inn here in White Orchard. Sole one around. Gets its share of travelers. Perhaps you'll learn something there? Besides, the innkeep's my cousin. Tell her Bram sent you. She'll treat you like family.
Not a bad idea. Especially since that wound needs cleaning.
Ah, beast barely grazed me. But sure, could use a good rye. Nice and cool, you know, straight from a cellar.
Let's go.
Uh-huh. Now, she'll treat me like family, but what if your family hates you?
Giddy up.
So, a griffon this close to the village? Strange.
My thoughts exactly. In the forest or the mountains, sure, but here? We're near the main road.
Maybe it's the war. Corpses everywhere, the stench of blood. Burnt flesh drives monsters crazy sometimes.
Men yeah, too. It does.
We need to watch ourselves in White Orchard, and we should leave as soon as we learn anything.
Don't disturb the peace. Remember, town guards and hired watchmen won't tolerate theft. And it also won't look kindly on accosting others. So I have to behave myself when I'm here. Fancy a mug of ale. Oh, what a bastard. Doesn't even notice her existence.
What?
Take that down before there's trouble.
That is a coat of arms, the Temerian lilies. They've a right to hang there.
This ain't Temeria no more, old man. It's Nilfgaard now.
My arse it is.
These guys have drunk a little bit too much. Oh, so sad.
What? Witches?
Yes, we're not folktale. We're real.
I'll not drink with Weaverlaw's freaks.
Beg your pardon for those thugs.
No need. We're used to it.
Folk are jumpy round here. Army's just passed through. Now a griffin's prowling about.
Mm-hmm. Already had the pleasure. Ran into your kinsman, Bram.
Bram? How is he?
Alive. Sends his regards.
Master witches. Food and drink on the house.
Aww.
What can I get you?
She's so nice. Let's do... Show me what you got. Why would I jump straight to...
Show me what you got behind the counter.
I'm looking for a woman right away. Okay, buy and sell items from the shop. I have 250. Let's see. I could start getting Gwent cards. They're a bit pricey, though. No, I don't need any food or drink, so let's just escape. Now let's ask her.
Raven-haired, violet eyes, dresses in black and white, riding in from Willoughby. And, strange as it sounds, lilac and gooseberries might have smelled that.
I've not seen nor smelt such a lady. Believe I'd remember.
Yeah, especially hard to forget this one.
Plenty of travellers about, though. Folk from all over. Might be worth your while to ask after her.
Yeah, true enough.
Pretty busy place you got.
Nations on the move. Some search for kin, others just want to get out of the way of the armies. They all need food, drink, and a night's rest in warmth.
So, war's been good for your trade?
Aye, so far. But it'd be best to know peace again. Times like these, you never know what tomorrow will bring.
True enough.
There a contract on that griffin?
Nay, not at the moment. Used to be. Soon as a beast had built a nest nearby, the alderman would start a collection, or go to the Lord for help. Now the aldermen don't use the privy without asking the Black One's permission first. And seems they hanged the Lord.
Oh.
So no contract.
Shame. We might have done something, but not for free.
Yeah, that's a tall tale to do for free.
Thanks for everything.
Like in real life, I'd basically be risking death. Like seriously risking death. Take out that griffin.
You bandage that up?
Please. I'm not decrepit yet.
God.
I'll ask about Yennefer.
Just wanted to help.
Just remember, we'd rather not draw any attention.
Black One's been out measuring the fields.
Let him measure. Better that than burning the harvest.
Oh, Drommel. Drommel, you're dumber than a headless cockerel. Why are they marking out them lines, eh? Passing out their patrimony.
I'm looking for someone.
And we seek some peace and quiet.
Out of my face, freak, for your breath sours my beer.
Ouch. Do I want to influence people's minds? Yeah, let's see if I can do it.
Raven-haired woman dressed in black and white. Seen her? Talk.
Folks say the lady rode through the village a few days back. Galloping so fast she knocked Radabor into a ditch.
Which way did she go?
Dunno. Lots of tracks leading off the main road. Could have gone anywhere.
Boy, people! The freak's taken Micah's mind!
Uh-huh. And I'll take your tongue if you don't shut up.
Wow. I'm very affirmative.
Be gone! We'll not talk to you.
Wow, he hates me already. Okay, that's the door out. I don't want to leave just yet. I want to talk to a few more patrons.
More. There are four factions.
Four what?
What a waste of time. The earth shall revolve around the sun before you comprehend these rules.
Got a minute?
Why not? Aldert Geert, Assistant Professor in Contemporary History at Oxenfurt Academy.
Oxenfurt?
Witcher, with tenure. I'm looking for a woman. Long hair, dressed in black and white. Seen anyone like that?
Of course not! Unlike the populace, I know the horsewoman of war is pure poppycock.
Horsewoman of war?
Not a place I'd ever expect to find a scholar. Take it you're fleeing the war?
Quite the opposite. Chasing it. I'm headed for the front.
Tired of life?
I seek knowledge, which I value more than life itself. I've a thirst no dusty old tomes can quench. I wish to see the Nilfgaardian invasion with my own eyes, understand it, and record it all in my chronicle, my magnum opus.
Huh.
Interesting. We need somebody to describe war, what it's really like. Not colorful banners and generals making moving speeches, but rape, violence, and thoughtless cruelty.
Ah, I see you lack the polish of the academy. Rape and cruelty are details of no import to the war's course. Trinkets on the garment of conflict, one might say.
Tell that to the people whose houses burned down.
Yeah, exactly. You're not... You don't want to write. You want to write like a poetic...
Horsewoman of war. What's that about?
Folks say an omen. A beautiful phantom rides the fields at night, looks as you described her. Armies follow her, and all who cross her path meet with misfortune.
I can vouch for the last bit.
No, facts interest me, not fairy tales.
But that is a fact.
War reached Novigrad yet?
Nope, but it's only a matter of time. Nilfgaard on one bank, Redania on the other. Drooling over the city like dogs over a juicy bone.
Many a ruler's choked on that bone.
True. We value our liberty in Novigrad, and we know how to fight for it.
Mm-hmm. The scholars especially.
Oh, snap.
The sword is not the only weapon. Do not forget, architects from our academy designed the city walls. Walls no war machine has ever crumbled.
Yet.
Gotta go. So long.
A moment, Witcher. You strike me as a man of the world. Are you familiar with Gwent?
No, and I don't have time to learn.
But the rules are quite simple. Come, let's play.
Let's play a little bit. And then we'll continue on with the story. I don't want to get caught up in Gwent too much, because I could spend hours playing this game. Gwent is an ancient dwarven game that simulates the clash of two armies in battle. Players are generals and the cards are their forces. You go first. To begin, you'll draw 10 cards. This will be your hand for the rest of the match. You will not draw any more cards, so use them wisely. This is a unit card. The number in the upper left corner indicates its strength. Pretty straightforward. When placed on the battlefield, this value is added to the total strength of the player who placed it. This is the unit's combat row icon. This icon indicates the row on the battlefield where the card can be played. So close combat's a sword, range combat's a bow, and siege combat is a siege engine. Some units have special abilities. This Siege Expert's special ability is called Morale Boost, which grants +1 strength to all units in the same row. Weather cards are a type of special card. They reduce the strength of all cards of a given type on the battlefield, including your own. At the start of each game, you can select up to two cards to discard and redraw. But let's skip that for now and go straight to playing. Here's the battlefield. This is your side. Opponent's side. Place one card on the battlefield or pass. Each deck has a leader. The leader grants you a special ability, which can be used only once during a battle. Trigger the special ability at any point by pressing X. My turn. Special leader, pick an impenetrable fog card from your deck and play it instantly. Wow. Oh, I didn't mean to play it. But maybe it'll work to my advantage. Let's go with him. Wow, he has a lot of archers, but so do I. Your opponent has passed. What is this? Torrential rain. Even the rain in this land smells like piss. Sets the strength of all siege combat to 1 for both players. And this one, strength of all close combat cards to 1 for both players. Okay, I guess I will pass this time. Let's pass. Uh-oh. That's not good. Okay, hit enter to apply. Oh wait, I meant to do close combat. Might as well block everything. What happened to all my cards, though? Ah, well. I suck at Gwent.
It's not a game for everyone.
It's not for me.
An analytical mind. If you ever find yourself in Oxenfurt and wish to play a true master, ask for Stepan. A simple innkeep by trade, but a true maestro when it comes to Gwent.
I'll remember that. Thanks.
I guess you could really get into Gwent if you really wanted to. Of course, the game is coming out as a digital standalone game, so that would be even cooler.
Looking for a woman.
Like everyone.
Like everyone. And not just any woman. Mine smells of lilac and gooseberries, dresses in black and white.
Two schnappsies. It'll lift your spirits.
At least say please.
Fine, I'll have a drink. Can we cut to the chase? You seen her or not?
Yennefer of Vengerberg.
Whoa, he knows her by name. That's impressive.
Never mentioned her name.
Yet you described her perfectly. And once I hear something, I never forget. Can't help it.
Let's see how he knows her.
Yennefer.
What a question. Master Dandelion's ballads, of course. The only way a humble merchant might hope to rub up against greatness. Unless, that is, he's as lucky as I am.
And runs into a very patient witcher.
Into Geralt of Rivia himself.
Subtle threat.
The Butcher of Blaviken.
Huh. Let's do... Who might you be first?
What do you do? Who are you?
A mangy vagrant. Gone to Rodim, at your service.
Vagrant, that a profession now?
Once a merchant of mirrors. The madding crowd dubbed me Master Mirror, or the Man of Glass.
Huh. Let's do, do you know who I am?
From Master Dandelion's ballads, too?
To your health.
He dodged the question.
You seen Yennefer?
Deepest apologies, but I must ask. Is this about love?
Why, yes, of course. I should say it's none of your business.
It's love.
I knew it at once.
What do you know? Tell me.
Before you appeared, it never occurred to me that might have been Yennefer. Who would have thought?
Get to the point.
An Ilf Guardian scout from the local garrison saw her.
Where?
At their camp. She rode in there. Dark of night, black and white, gooseberries and... Yes, I know. Had a terse exchange with the garrison commander and raced off.
Where to?
I'm not omniscient. Ask at the garrison.
Thanks.
So I'm only getting bits and pieces of
the
info.
The men on the road must stick together. Perhaps one day I'll be in trouble and you'll be nearby to help.
Oh, I don't remember that. Did he just vanish? Like, he just up and vanished. Do I need to talk to my buddy again? I don't think I even talked to him the first point.
Realize it's been half a year since we hunted down that fiend in Varun.
It's been half a year since I played this game. Actually, no, it's been almost a year since I played this game.
What's that bastard's name? Drugan? May the soil lie light upon him. Things used to be simpler. Monsters were bad, humans good. Now, everything's all confused.
Used to be exactly the same. You've just forgotten.
Do well not to point up my age. You're near a century old yourself.
That'd be cool. To live that long and still be young. Though I have heard that... I believe scientists have said that they believe the first human being that will be... That will likely hit the age of 140 has already been born.
Then fuck off.
Whoa. Wow, don't you're, want your you're violent. Here.
Better round up someone else to help. Three of you don't stand a chance against me.
Well, I could fuck you up by myself.
If I had a bag over my head and my hands tied behind. Actually, no, not even then.
Chet, Lesh, back off. I'll teach this vagrant a lesson. Man on freak.
Wow, clocked them in no time. Oh, let's see. How far do I have to go? Oh, there's jobs here. On the notice board. But I have to get here.
What kind of name is that anyway? Durban.
Nilfgaard. My gran was from Nevers.
Ouch! We'll take them, but we'll focus on the major story, and then when I'm not online, I'll do the minor ones. Or when I'm not recording, I'll do the minor ones.
What happened here?
Oh, got a wee bit chilly tonight, so I set fire to my forge.
Hey, he's a dwarf.
Got it nice and roaring. Roasted some wieners. What do you think happened, dimwit? Some bugger set alight me workshop. I've lost everything. Everything!
Let's do the don't insult
Easy
me.
On the insults. I could add to your misfortune. Any suspects?
Whole damned village. I've lived here half a century. Thought they saw me as one of their own. But everything changed when the black ones came. I'm the only smith around, so I got to service their garrison. Bang dent out of plate, shoe horses. That sort of thing. Nilfgaardians don't pay me a bloody copper. Just give me supplies and orders. But humans can't fathom that. They think I'm getting rich off their misfortune. That I sleep on a pile of gold like a plowing dragon. They've stopped talking to me. Spit when I pass. And now this.
Well, they call me a freak and I just got here. Let's play the I need money card.
I can find your arsonist, provided you're willing to pay.
I've not much left, but I'll give you all if you bring me that horse in, so that he gets what he deserves. The night of the fire, I heard movement outside my hut. Went out to see if I could find any tracks, but found nothing. But then I haven't got cat eyes, have I? Good luck.
Maybe I do have to do some of the side quests while I'm doing this in order to keep my level up. Okay, quests updated. Notification will appear on the left side of the screen. If you're not currently tracking the updated quest, you can press V to start tracking it. Alright, so let's summon my horse. Where are you, Roach? I don't see ya. Oh, there you are. All right, let's go. Looks like someone needs help down here. Might as well pick up the quests while I'm going.
Lost your key, ma'am?
No, not me key. Me pan. It always sat there empty, this hurt. That is, till the night afore the battle. A man arrived, walked right in like 'twere his own. He was standing at my window, peering at the goings on. He must have eyed me, 'cause next I knew, there he was, coming my way. So, I grabbed me pan for protection, see? But he just asks all polite, Gran, got any birch bark by chance? Lilac berries or even a few coals? Nay, says I, and you must be right daft to pester folk at night with such foolery. But I sees he ain't listening, just staring at me pan like a magpie at a copper. Lend it to me, Gran, I'll give it back come morn. He was right baffled for what's he doing, frying in the dark. But I've got a soft heart, so I gave it to him.
Aww.
Interesting. What happened then?
Afore dawn, another rode up to the hut. But come morn, only the first fella left. Locked the door, hopped on his horse, and that were all I saw of him, and me pan. 'Twere old, black with soot, not worth much, I suppose. But I've no other. Will you help me, dearie? Bring an old widower pan. I could never break down that door myself. And in truth, I'm afeard to go in any wood. Such a stench wafting out.
Oh, someone's dead.
Well, he's lying there.
He must be dead.
Never taken on a pan contract. Fine, I'll go in, look around. You should wait here, just in case.
Alright, object can be destroyed. Alright. Okay, I don't need any of those quick act. Oop, nope. I need Ard. Ooh. She's not here, so I could probably loot this and get away with it. I shouldn't steal from an old woman. I don't need a smoking pipe.
A corpse. Explains the stench.
Yeah, he's dead all right. Now, the one thing I need to do, though...
His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind of soldier might have.
What's that, dearie?
Nothing, nothing.
I already searched him.
He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind of soldier might have.
But when I gab to myself, they say I don't scar me.
There's her pan.
The priceless frying pan. Scrubbed clean. Looks like the mystery man didn't need the pan so much as the soot off it to make ink, write letters.
Well, she's got a sparkling pan. God, I'm just looting everything. Just stealing stuff at will. Oh wait, there's something there.
Documents, almost entirely burned. A few pieces still legible.
Yes, I did. Stop nagging me, lady.
Here, your frying pan.
Mine? But mine were black with soot. And I could see myself in this sun if I wanted. but them years are past.
It was the soot the man needed. He scraped it off to make ink. Must have had an urgent letter to write. Urgently burned some other documents, too.
And...
she doesn't need to know all
and
that.
And the other fellow?
Dead. Round up a few boys and bury him outside the village. Deep, so the necrophages don't dig him up. And take my advice. Don't mention this to the Nilfgaardians.
Hang about! You've earned a token of thanks. Here, son. For the road.
Aww. Sweet old lady. Okay, and with this side quest, we'll call it an episode, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Hi everyone, I just want to say thank you very much for watching this video. Please give this video a like, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll be posting many more videos in the future. Thank you very much, and have a fantastic day.